or they try to.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
You're now listening to Music Mpulse with Smilez.
This episode, we got a returning guest, superstar rapper, lady alkaline, fine alkaline, everything positive. She's just an amazing just person. She done hooked me up with some good products before in the past, you know, everything to help me live a better lifestyle and eat a little bit better. Even though I still ain't on her level, you know, I'll be also taking her smoothie recipes when she be posting her smoothie recipes online and everything. Yeah. Former guest going through not just a name change, but, you know, a lifestyle change, you know. When she came on before, she went by Lethal. You know, we're going to talk about her new project that she got coming out. This, you know, talking about how she this is the last time you're going to hear her going under the name Lethal. But, you know, I got my girl Cyletha in the building. You know what I'm saying? How you doing?
Hey, I am fine. How are you?
I'm doing good. But, you know, we were just talking about life and everything real quick before we got on. But really just, I just get to it about... You know, met you before, you know, you was out here in Dallas doing your thing, you know, tearing up stages. Mm-hmm. I remember meeting you because of Lil D and everything. But you recently moved back home to Arkansas. I really just want to start off right there. What was the whole meaning behind going back home? I know, like, in one of your vlogs you dropped recently, you were talking about how taking a step out on faith to truly be free and living your purpose. But, you know, just go into that a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, so, like, basically, I had been wanting to run away from Dallas for a while because I had been out there for, like,
I think you said 13 years.
Yeah, 13, almost 14 years. And first it was me. I was ready to move out of the country. I was ready to move to Ghana because I'm like, I was just had my awakening, and I'm like, okay, it's about to mess up stuff going on. I'm ready to go to Africa. Mm-hmm. And I was about to go, but, you know, the pandemic hit, and I still was ready to go, but my mama was like, no, ma'am.
She's like, we got a whole disease wrecking the whole right. whole world right now.
Yeah, and I'm like, ma, they got... I'm trying to tell my mama and my stepdaddy at the time, like, it's really cheap out there. But they was like, no. And so I'm like, okay, I'll go back to the drawing board. And then I was going to get me an RV and travel the world and just be free with that. And that didn't work out for me. You know how when you try something and it just, like, gotta be like, nope. And so I was like, okay, I go back to the drawing board. I ended up staying back in Dallas for a little bit longer. But then some things that had happened with the pandemic and stuff, you know, losing family members. I had lost my stepdad. And
sorry about that.
A lot of that stuff had taken... Thank you. And so I was coming home more often, checking on my mama, and just wanting to be close to the family. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't really have family out there in Dallas. And it was just getting to the point where I was getting homesick. And then I was going home. Because the thing about going to Ghana, the reason why is, like, when you go to Ghana, they have, at one particular time, I don't know if they still have it, but they have, like, free land out there for the diaspora. But you have to have a plan for the community. see what you can bring to the community and all that stuff. You know, I'm coming up with plan and all that stuff. As I was going home to visit, I'm riding around town, and it was reminding me of, like, when I was in Jamaica and the islands and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, dang, like, everything, a lot of the stuff that I was running away to get to, which was like nature, a lot of nature, mm-hmm. and just a slowdown. I'm like, you know what? I can get that in my hometown. And actually, my hometown is very small, good, but it's like predominantly Black. And I've seen like so many people move away from there and just gave up the hope of, you know, my hometown. But I'm like, I see a blank canvas and I see a lot of potential. And I feel like this is the time now for us to, you know, invest in the land and, mm-hmm. and bring our city back, you know, versus letting somebody to come in the community that don't know nothing about the community and, you know, put money into the community and bank off of it. So I bought some land like the year before last out here.
I was just like,
you know what? I'm about to. I gave my, you know, I used to do hair. I put a date on it. And I was like, I'm done doing hair, and I'm going back home. And everybody thought I was crazy. And even my friends here, they was just like, "You really want to come back here? I don't know if you want to do that." And I'm like, "I do." I came back home and man, that I needed it big time. I needed it. And I'm so happy, like I'm so grateful. And I'm like, dang, what took me so long?
Yeah, you're from a small town, but then living out here in Dallas for like 13, 14 years. I don't know, what was that like having a transition from, you know, the city life that you'd been in the last 13, 14 years to going back to, like, again, like a more natural, smaller, like slower paced lifestyle? How was that transition was for you? How was that for you?
It was really good, only because that's really what I needed, because it was getting to the point where, like, the thing about, you know, living out there in a city, it was good for opportunity wise and money wise, you know, mm-hmm. but I was in survival mode the whole time, because, you know, for about almost half the time I was there, I struggled. And so it got to the point where I was running so many different businesses, and like I almost didn't even want to go to sleep for real at night, because I'm trying to make sure, you know, I got the money flowing.
Yeah.
So I just was always trying to escape that and, you know, take a vacation and stuff like that. And then, but me going to Arkansas was like a woo-sah all the time.
Yeah, you know, you said you got tired of living in that rat race.
Right, exactly. So, man, it's been like, it's like my central nervous system has calmed down, you know. I've learned how to, I've gotten more into my meditation practice, mm-hmm. Which is something that I started when I was in Dallas, but I didn't get deep into it. I only did like a little bit of it. Mm-hmm. And but I was actually able to really, because I'm a big faith person. Mm-hmm. But I would say this past year, you know, I really had to operate on faith, because I quit my, you know, my career and started mm-hmm. over. And so in my meditation practice, it helped me to understand how to release, control, and allow for the, you know, the blessings to roll in the way that it's gonna roll in without you having control over it, you know. Mm-hmm. So I feel like that helped with me moving back home. That helped with all of that. It wasn't bad for me. I was craving it. So
yeah, and then like along with that, I've seen you've done like a lot of traveling and doing different experience and stuff like that. Like one of the videos I saw, you went hiking for the first time out in LA. What was that like, doing that for the first time? And then have you done anything since then? Any more hiking since then?
So all the videos, my vlogs and stuff that I've been uploading goes back to like 2020.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's when I actually did my first hike in 2020.
Okay.
And yeah, so I've been hiking. I've done it like a couple times. I did like hiking in Hot Springs, and then I did the hiking in LA. And hiking in Arizona.
That's what I want to do, Arizona, because one of my two of my homies, one of them actually just moved to Dallas like maybe like 3 years ago. But him and another homie, when they was out in Arizona, they would go hiking all the time. And I'm like, yo, I want to go out there to visit y'all just so I can do it with y'all for like one time.
Arizona, it was so beautiful out there. I was out in Sedona.
Okay.
And I actually had, thankfully, I had one of my clients to accompany me out there because I was going to take a solo trip out there and do my hiking thing. And I'm so glad that, you know, my client came with me because he had experience with hiking out there in Arizona. Mm-hmm. So he helped guide me on the hikes and stuff like that. And that, oh my gosh, it was like the scenery. They got some beautiful mountains out there, and like it's some really sacred places out there. So yeah, it's dope out there. You can feel the energy. Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Yeah, that's dope. Yeah, I definitely, cause one of the homies, shout out to the homie Enrico. He still live out in Arizona. He actually just like you. He living his alkaline life. He eat his greens. You know, smoke his green, and still hiking and doing all that, doing like his photography and stuff like that. But I definitely say like, yo, I need to take a trip out there just so I can do that hiking with him for one time.
Yes, Arizona is a vibe. Like. Yeah, and I noticed they have a lot of like healing resorts and stuff out there too.
Okay, that's dope.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I definitely look into that. Also, like, what's some other things you've been up to over the last year? Have you done any other traveling or anything?
So I haven't done much traveling this past year, only because I kind of. Cause like I said, I've been operating on faith.
Yeah.
And with my business finding alkaline, I pretty much, even though I didn't start it last year, I pretty much started from the bottom and started rebuilding it.
Mm-hmm.
So I did a lot of, I'm sure you see me like setting up on the highway and stuff like that. So I did a lot of groundwork for finding alkaline.
I saw you going out getting fresh stuff. Like, hey, we're going to get the fresh water and everything.
And it's just amazing because we got the spring water here, like, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So we can go and get it for free. So that's amazing. So yeah, I've just been enjoying the simple things in life, like being able to go outside barefooted, ground my feet in the grass, you know, just stuff like that. Being able to be with my family and kick it with them, kick it with my mama, just that's the stuff I've been enjoying this past year. Because typically, like I said, I would take vacations to escape, and since I came to a place where, you know, I got what I needed, I'm like, I don't have to run away right now. Anyways, I do plan on doing more traveling, you know, here in the future. But I just, you know, I didn't have that desire this past year. So that was cool.
Oh, yeah, that's dope. Because you're like, heck yeah, I don't, like you said, I have no fear, no feeling of having to escape. Like, I just need a break from everything in life. That again, like that rat race, I need to get off the wheel like for a few days, a week or whatever, and whatnot. Yes. It's like, I'm relaxed, I'm chill, I'm not stressing.
And another I know you asked me what I've been, what else I've been up to, and as I thought about it, like I basically just explored all of my creative talents this past year, which was, you know, not other than, you know, my holistic health. You know, I started making crystal jewelry, and I also got into DJing.
Okay.
Yeah.
I saw you're also a podcaster now. I saw that.
And it's so crazy because I do it every day, but sometimes I forget I do it. But yeah, podcasting.
So what's that been like?
Yeah, so it's been cool. Like, it's been pretty dope to like get my words out, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's been cool. That's me and my best friend.
Cousin P.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. So these are conversations that we have anyways. And we both was talking about, you know, starting a podcast, and we talked about doing some work together. Mm-hmm. So our first podcast happened to be us collabing. So it was fitting, and shout out to the Real Underground radio station. That's where we at, and you know, they making some noise out here in Arkansas. So it's a beautiful thing, you know. We getting, it's like the radio world, so we're getting the gist of the whole media thing. But it's like I've dabbled in it, but I just haven't, you know. But it's just another wing to the entertainment,
creative aspect of you.
Right. And it's gotten me to just see, like, even with that and, like, my, all of, like, with my brand and stuff like that, I've been doing a lot of video editing, a lot of technical stuff, you know?
Yeah, that's what I wanted to ask you about, too, because it's like, yeah, you've become, like, again, more of a vlogger. I've seen you really get more into social media, posting on, like, TikTok and Instagram and all that. So, it's like, I've definitely seen you growing and developing more creatively and all that.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, it's some work behind it, but I'm like, man, my resume is... I got some skills now.
Because I've seen some TikTok. I'm like, man, I was like, she got like a new TikTok like every day. Like,
yeah.
I was like, and it was all, like,
at one point I was posting like my TikToks every day. Right now I'm on a streak of posting a vlog a day. So.
Yeah.
Because that's one of my biggest things. I really want to build my YouTube following.
Plus, you never know, like, what video could catch on and be the one that gets everybody going.
Right. And I have so much footage in my phone because I vlog, you know, anytime I'm getting some kind of experience.
Yeah.
So, like all the vlogs you have seen is dated. But I'm like, it's even though it's old to me, it's new to y'all, so it's always going to be good content.
I can't remember who was the hiking video one. I know, like, because I was just looking at your hair. I was like, one of the ones I saw, like, your hair was, like, super long in it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
So I was like, she can grow her hair more and all that.
Nah, that was a weave.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And that right there was not the brightest decision with me to go hiking with that long hair. Man, I was like the female Tarzan out there.
Like the female Tarzan.
Man, I was having fights with them trees and stuff. Ooh, it was bad. It was bad.
You're like, all right.
I had trees and sticks and plants all in my head. It was crazy.
You like, make sure, all right, no weed next time I go hiking.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
That's dope. But again, you know, the music is... When did you know, like, hey, I want to make this change from the Lethal name? Because I know I was reading, like, your post about, like, yo, that was, like, a girl that was, like, you know, insecure and everything. And then, like, well, what went into you finally, like, being like, you know what? I want to, like, part of my whole transition and my change was I want to change my name, go with my real name, and all that.
Man, if you would have told me 6 months ago that I was going to have an idea to change my name, I wouldn't believe you. Because I never thought I would part ways with Lethal. Mm-hmm. But towards the end of last year, I did a cleanse. Mm-hmm. I cleansed for almost 60 days. And I was about 30 days into the cleanse when I started getting like so many downloads and all these great ideas and stuff like that. And I know that that's how it go. You know, when you all the way, you know, clean, mm-hmm. like the elevation, like everything is just heightened. And so you'll have all of these downloads, all of these bright ideas and all of this stuff. So I was ready to take advantage of this. So once that came, I just started jotting down everything. And then on top of that, I'd be listening to, you know, different videos and stuff on marketing and all of that stuff. And what happened was I was riding and I ended up clicking on a video and it was a guy talking about your business, how your business can be successful, but he got to talking about your name, your business name, and he was saying that more of the successful people, they're successful because of their personal brand, mm-hmm. because of their personal name. And he talked about like Elon Musk or whatever, and he was like, basically anything that he attached his name to is gonna be successful. And then he talked about like Louis Vuitton, all of these like luxury brands, they're all names. Mm-hmm. Either last names, first names, or whatever. And I was like, oh, okay. So it kind of sparked the light bulb at that time. And then that day, it just really hit me. And I feel like the algorithm and everything that I watch and stuff, it's like I see it at the right time. And it hit me, and I'm like, you know what? I think I might need to part ways with Lethal, because when I think about how Lethal got started, mm-hmm. and like where I'm at now with the music, it's totally different, you know. And the stuff that I used to say, I don't even have the guts to say now, you know. You know, and when I started off doing the music, it was more of an outlet of me getting my frustrations out. Mm-hmm. But I became aware of that the fact that, you know, I got a lot of people looking up to me, like, you know, young girls, mm-hmm. grown women looking up to me. So I'm like, the stuff that I was saying, I'm like, okay, I might need to scale back a little bit, you know. So that's when I started slowing down on the stuff that I was saying, and I was going through stuff, and I started being more conscious of what I would call myself. You know, I stopped calling myself a bad bitch, and, you know, I just slowly started removing, you know, different stuff out of my vocabulary, and I just started being more conscious about what I was putting out there. And I'm like, you know, I got these people looking up, especially once I went through the different stuff that I went through. I'm like, I can't leave my people, you know what I'm saying? Like, when I'm here, I can't go backwards, and it's just like, I gotta leave them with something that they can really, you know, take from. And so, you know, now I'm like, my last project, Emotionally Unavailable, most of my songs is like, it's kind of spiritual in a way, you know?
Yeah, that's what I was like. I was like, well, that project, that's when I could see like that transition already happening.
Right, right. So it's like, okay. And I had to think about it. And then now I'm really, because for a long time I did have like issues with relationships and stuff like that, and a lot of that was the root of Lethal too, you know what I'm saying? Because she had to come out to play when, you know, they played on my top. So now now Lethal got to come out and be an asshole, you know what I'm saying? So now I'm in a relationship that I'm proud of, and that I don't feel like I need her, because I already feel protected. I don't need Lethal to protect me, you know. Mm-hmm. I feel safe where I'm at, and I didn't, even this past year too, I've been working on like being more feminine, and I've been studying how, you know, being a valuable woman, because it's just been a whole thing, like, but I was in a constant cycle of like, basically I was giving too much,
and not
getting enough energy in return, and I'm drained, you know. Yeah.
Again, like, you know, kind of get back to the music. So you got this new mixtape that you dropping, so this episode's gonna drop on the 10th, so as of tomorrow, you know, the project drops on the 11th, you know. What was the inspiration from dropping this? Is it like a collection of just all new music, or some new, some old? Like, tell us behind that, and then about how, like, we're gonna transition to Cyletha Marcelette.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
Been moving big lows on the low low. I don't brag all the time, but it shows though. Can't get too close if you're so-so. Rather move around this bitch on my dolo. Ayy, good vibes only, I smoke it with the sage. Coming in my lane might get you roll rage. My ex wanna redo, I'm trying to turn the page. Should've called me when you had me, now I am not the same. Price just went up and I am not to blame. Just had an intervention with myself on some things. Back to the drum, boy, shit is looking strange. I had to tell myself, can't be fucking with them lanes. I was looking at potential, but why when I'm a fish? I can't be tending to these little boy issues. I'm tired of the shit, I'm out of tissue. The same list of kisses, they're dishes. And now I'm shoe slugs, just be telling my story. Everything's smooth right now, ain't always been the glory. I can't trip when I realize she ain't for me. It is what it is, just a part of my journey. Take the good with the bag, yeah. First I cry, hit the joint and go harder when I get to the bag, yeah. I want mine and all cash, yeah. I got that dope shit, good quality, no trash, yeah. On my alkaline shit, real the divine shit. I'm some ton of vision, I ain't got the time, shit. First time I see a switch, I'ma change my mind quick. I don't see no competition, my life too lit. I'm blessed, I'm blessed. Life is what you make it, don't stress. I got a real message, I'm a mess. And yeah, I play the role, I confess. I lie, don't care who tell it or smell it. Protect yourself, don't inhale it.
It's your girl, Lethal. And I'm not sorry for the wake. I'm just saying, for real. But look, I've been on some other shit lately. Steady growing to a different person on the daily. Clearing out my chakras, Reiki when I'm meditating. They still sending screenshots to my ex and I'm elated. Oh, I ain't got the patience and I ain't clearing nothing. I'm just over here taking 50-11 vacations. Living my best life cause I don't know my expiration. My life really a movie, I can't tell misinformation. I know
know I'm inspiration. So therefore, gotta watch what I do, cause I'm an angel with two sides and we be fucking up too. I had opened my third eye, then I got out of the loop, cause my vibration's way too high to be fucking with you. Why you gotta act like that? Why you gotta be so white and black? Why you can't give me like 50-11 chances? Why you can't take me back? Man, cause I've been on a mission. Got too many years up in the kitchen. And I can't chill if we can't live. It don't coincide with the vision. Nah, why do you wanna test my gangster though? Why do you wanna test my gangster? Why do you wanna test my gangster? Why do you wanna test my gangster though? Why do you wanna test my gangster? Assets on assets, gotta get the bag, let go of the baggage. Hey, why do you wanna test my gangster though? Why do you wanna test my gangster? Why do you wanna test my gangster? Why do you wanna test my gangster though? Why do you wanna test my gangster? Assets on assets, gotta get the bag, let go of the baggage. Look, I've been on some other shit lately. Been here for so long and ain't nobody come and save me. I had to risk it all, can't shoot my shot when it's on safety. I used to ask my guy why me, but that's the shit that make me. The world is going crazy, I go within it, save me. I willow like the tree, but some will see and call it wavy. I'm planted with my roots, I grow and shine, they call it shady. A country girl at heart, but not gon' lie, the city paid me. Shout out the ones that played me. My ancestors don't play, I'm the truth. Cause I got angels with two sides and they will fuck you up too. I had opened my third eye, then I got out of the loop. Cause my vibration's way too high to be fucking with you. I've been on some other shit lately.
So the mixtape, Not Sorry for the Wake, like you said, dropping January 11th. So basically it's me jacking all the beats. I've done a lot of like quote unquote freestyles of me, you know, in my car or different stuff like that, rapping on different other people beats. So what I decided to do, I put most of them, because a lot of these songs that I've done, like car raps and quote unquote freestyles, I never put them on a track. So these past few ones, I'm like, now I mean, I go hard on all of them. I'm going to just say that. I go hard on all of them.
You do.
Yeah, so I'm like, I got to put this. Because a lot of people, too, they be like, I want to bump this, you know? So I'm like, okay. I want to put all of my cover songs. Well, these are all of my cover songs during my awakening.
Yeah.
So I ain't going to say all of them, but most of them.
Yeah.
And I did leave some off, but some you have heard a verse or something from it, but you have not heard it recorded.
Okay.
And then some I sprinkled some new songs in there too.
Okay, okay.
So yeah, it's gonna be 10 songs on the project. So I feel like it's going to show a bit of my versatility, because I got different speeds going on. And another thing that I'm proud of on the project, I'm actually able to, for one, I'm recording myself. I'm doing this whole project myself.
Okay, okay.
And I'm able to record in the comfort of my home. And I'm just more comfortable on the track. I'm able to, like, really indulge in the track and see where I can flow in there instead of me. Because typically it was me writing a song, going in a studio, and, you know, putting it on the track.
Yeah.
But it's hard to, like, it was just hard for me to really merge with the track, you know, per se. So that's what I've been working on doing, just working on more like harmonization and yeah, just just getting that feel good and actually letting people get the sound of what I bring, the versatility that I bring. Yeah.
Okay, that's dope. Can't wait to check this out. Again, you know, dropping tomorrow on the 11th, you know. I'm not sorry for the wait.
And it's only, I'm only going to have it on my website.
Okay, get the website.
Not sorry for the wake.myshopify.com.
Okay.
That's the only place you'll be able to download the mixtape. It's only $5. The only other place you may be able to hear it is on my YouTube when I upload them on there, but you won't be able to listen to it on anything else. And I'm thinking about doing my future projects like that. Just going straight independent, because like this whole distributing thing is just, I'm not seeing any return from it. So, you know, I'm trying to, I'm making it make sense.
Hey, look at guys like LaRusso and Russ. They like give it straight to the people. Like, I'll make the money over time as I build up my clientele and, you know, my fandom and all that. And plus, like, doing it straight to like your own avenue is like, I get to see the real, like, okay, who's really supporting me? Like, so I've even seen like LaRusso talk about, like, yo, like when we do these tours and these routes, it's like, she's like, okay, we got this many people that bought the album here. Like, oh, we can do like even like a little pop-up shop. I don't care if it is 5 people, 10 people. I know those 20 people that's going to come, or like people who are willing to, like, because I know he does like some of those pay it forward like type things. Is like, hey,
okay,
I could do a pop-up show saying like, hey, you pay whatever you want to get into the concert. And he's like, I can have somebody like, oh, I want to give $10. But then I might have someone who like really loves my music, like, no, I'm willing to pay $100 to go see you. And he's like, okay, I may have made only $220 from it, but one of those people gave me $100.
Yes. And somebody, I had my sister-in-law, she was introducing me to another artist that actually do that too. Like, when he sell his music, he allow people to just pay what they think is worth. And so I may consider that for my next project. That sounds like a great idea, but that whole, I'm not finna wait on another stream or another streaming summary at the end of the year, because it ain't finna play with my head.
Yeah.
I don't care. I'll take 50 downloads of my mixtape versus a million streams right now.
Yeah, like, you'll get paid more money off of it too.
Yeah.
It's like I'm making $1.99 for 1,000 streams.
Yes, right, exactly. I'm like, it's giving sweatshops. Like, no. I done put so much money and time into this, I gotta make it make sense.
Yeah, like when you hear somebody like Snoop Dogg saying like, oh yeah, Spotify said I had like a million billion streams, but then when I looked at the check and I'm like, I only got like $10,000 off like 15 billion streams. What does that title give me? All you did was give me $10,000.
And just imagine if you really got all of that money. Just imagine who really getting paid.
Exactly.
Off your hard work.
But
yeah, it's just, to me, it's another form of believing in a man. And I just don't believe in a man.
Right. You'd rather just go believe in yourself and the support that you get.
Exactly.
Like, because this way you can, again, like with the vlog stuff, just putting like maybe a song an episode or a song a vlog or whatever, and and over time people will be like, oh, like, oh, like for example, for an Audible Ruckus, the other podcast I do with my homies, Lo, he's actually working on his own project, and I remember the one of the songs he played for me, I was like, yo, this is fire. This is really like, he was like, did you notice anything about it? I was like, what? He was like, You know that's one of the beats that we use underneath the podcast, because when he posts the podcast, he plays like instrumentals. He was like, yeah, he was like, he's like, that instrumental is one of the instrumentals I use for the episodes. I was like, what? He was like, yeah. He's like, so subconsciously, that's why you already liked it, because you're so used to hearing it in the background, but because I'm rapping to it, you I was like, oh, wow, that's amazing.
That was smart.
Yeah, I was like that is really smart. He was like, yeah, I used one of the songs that we used for the podcast, and I rapped over it.
Yeah. Hey, that's genius.
Mm-hmm. So, like, you can do that with your video, because after a while, people are like, oh, yeah, what's that one you always play at the end of every video or at the beginning of every video?
Right. And I do... That's one thing I do. I make sure I incorporate my music into my blogs and stuff like that, because honestly, that's when I get a return from it, like when I put it in my blog. So,
because people are like, oh, you're like, oh, yeah, that's actually number 6 off my latest project. If you want to hear that and more, just pay the $5 at the website. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. But what else? Besides the music that we got coming out now, is there anything else you are already like preparing for with this transition? Is there like any other differences you know that you want to make, or that you see that you're going to be making with the music?
Let's see. Well, I know I'm going to be releasing more projects this year. So I have an album that I'm already in the works, or an EP that I'm already in the works on. And then I have some more work that I'm doing too. So I really want to get more into like manifestation music and all of that, and which my music is like in the line of that. But again, I just let it flow. But like I said, I do plan on, I'm hoping to release like 2 more projects this year.
Okay.
And I actually, I think I'm gonna be dabbling more into, to getting some visuals out there too. Visuals.
Yeah.
I know that right there is a big key.
Yeah.
So hopefully I can unlock that. But I'm actually may do a film.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
It's gonna go hand in hand. I actually have like 2 films that I'm thinking about doing. But I got an idea, you know, so we'll see how that play out. But it'll all go hand in hand with everything that I got going, along with my story and all of that. So
okay, looking forward to that. Okay, excited about that. But other than that, anything else you want to let the folks know before we wrap it up?
Like I said, make sure y'all can download the pre-sale today.
Okay.
And you can go ahead and download the pre-sale. You'll be the first to get your download for the mixtape. If not, you know, you can catch it when it drops. Make sure y'all follow me on all platforms. My new name is Cyletha Marcelette, so that's my name on all platforms now. If you've been following me, you'll see that. And then follow the brand, find it alkaline. If you on your healing journey, your self-healing journey, y'all shop with the brand. You know, we got multivitamins, we got all herbal capsules, topical oil blends, all of this holistic healing where you don't have to use this over-the-counter medicine, and we can heal in the household. So find an alkaline. Okay, no, for real.
They do drop off. She put up to the crib and dropped it off to me.
yes. So yeah. findingalkaline.com. And I also have a free ebook, How to Get Your Chakras Aligned. You can go on there and download that for free. And, you know, I got more things coming with the business. So it's just up. It's up from here. But Cyletha Marcelette is that's the new name. So after this project drop, like I said, it's gonna be my last project as Lethal. Then Cyletha Marcelette is coming with a fresh new sound, you know. And hopefully I can rub off on y'all, rub some light off on y'all.
All right. Dope.
And the podcast, The Morning Tea off GP. Y'all can follow us on all platforms, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. We're on The Real Underground Radio. DFW
too. Okay, that's what's up. I'll check them out.
Yep. So I guess that's about it. I really do appreciate you for having me on here and being able to promote my project. And you know, we got round two. Like, you know, I appreciated the first time you brought me on, and I thank you for following me on my journey and, you know, staying tapped in. So I appreciate that.
Oh yeah, anytime. Because again, I just think you're dope just in general. So I'm like, just from the music, I was like, oh, she's dope. And then just seeing like, oh, yeah, she's into this like alkaline positive lifestyle. Like, it motivates me to like do better and try better every day. So
yes, well, that's so good. That's so good. I love to see it.
Yeah, because I'm like, I may not make it to her level one day, but at least I can try.
Yeah, and I see you. I be seeing your posts and, you know, your baby steps. And that's what really matters, those baby steps. You know, I see when you post and you're like, okay, I switched over to this, you know. So it's just those small changes that, it elevates you. So I love to see it.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. I appreciate it. But this is your boy, Smiles. I'm here with Cyletha Marcelette. This has been another episode of the Music Mpulse, and we out.
Bye.